We are going to see 10 ways of using the function tooltip in Excel. Whenever you are writing or editing a formula, you see this tooltip. It tells you in one line what the function does. The second benefit is it's showing me similar functions. Now, most of us use some function, but some SQ is something you may not have ever noticed. Read their names and look at what it does. And if you find something interesting, by all means, go and learn it. The second one, it'll show you the function syntax. Of course, if you're not familiar with the syntax, you can press Ctrl A, go to this dialog and learn each parameter in detail. But if you just want to brush up your memory and make sure you're not making mistakes, look at this syntax. Anything which is in square brackets is optional. And anything which has three dots, that means it is a repetitive parameter. In some function, you can have one or two or many numbers, basically. The fifth benefit is to know exactly where you are. This is a complex nested set of functions. If I click somewhere, I know I am inside the filter function and in the array parameter. If I just move it a little, notice now I am specifying the array parameter of choose_calls function. That makes it easier to type and troubleshoot formulas. Sixth benefit is hyperlinks. Complex functions, while you are typing, you may forget exactly how to use parameter 4. And now you don't want to go away from your editing. I'm still editing the formula. I don't want to press escape, then go to help, come back. So that's where this hyperlink, which is very commonly missed, is useful. Click on it. You are still editing the function. Now the help appears, so you can clarify your doubts, look at an example, and now when you are happy with it, when you come back here, the function is still being edited. So you can learn the syntax on the fly while you are editing. The seventh benefit is hyperlinks with these parameters. When you click on a parameter, it actually selects that parameter. So notice, if I click on the array parameter, this whole function within a function within a function is the parameter. It's very difficult to do it manually. You will have confusion with commas and brackets, but this hyperlink is an absolute lifesaver. Here is another brilliant benefit of that hyperlink. Here is a formula I have already written. And after writing it, I realized, oh, this should have been dollar sign. Now what am I going to do? Click there and press F4 for dollar. But that's not going to work across the range. That's really sad. And now I'm going to undo, select all this manually. That's where this selection is very useful. So select and one F4 will put dollar signs. But that's not all. That hyperlink has other benefit as well. For example, I'm trying to troubleshoot this complex formula and I don't know what is happening here. So I go to if error. Inside if error, I highlight the value portion, which happens to be all this. And now it's telling me there is a hash name error. I am able to troubleshoot parts of the formula. It also shows me arrays. So for example, if I click here, notice in the tooltip itself, I am seeing the whole array. Of course, not the whole array, because tooltip has its own limit, but it helps me in troubleshooting. Now this tooltip showing the executed version is only available in the Office 365 version of Excel. If you don't have that, or if you want to see the whole output, then you press F9 or the calculate key. So thing which is highlighted will be executed. So it actually put that whole array here. This is called inline editing, and it's difficult to scroll and figure out what is happening. If you are trying to do this kind of troubleshooting, then this is better because this gives you a more controllable scroll bar to debug what you're doing. Remember, we have just replaced your formula with the actual values. So undo still works while you are editing the formula. So tooltip will help you view result and F9 will help you insert the result. The 10th benefit. While you're editing long formulas, this tooltip may overlap your formula because the formula itself is long. Now what do you do? Well, take your cursor to the tooltip. We are not clicking on any hyperlink right now, but at some point it becomes four-headed arrow, typically in the beginning, just before the function. And now four-headed arrow, you can move this tooltip itself and get it out of the way of your editing. So there you have it, 10 brilliant benefits of function tooltips. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.